The number one thing that shocks everybody in my book, Blackout, I talk about payola. That's where individuals are paid to play music. I've talked about it to FCC commissioners. I've been all over the country. I've explained how it happened. The introduction of my book talks about Karen Klein. Karen Klein is the name of the FedEx that used to come every Saturday for programmers. I talk about when I went to program BET after leaving New York, working New York radio. I checked into my hotel and 4 days later on Saturday, I had those three envelopes with $100 bills that totaled $30,000 in cash. And I'll be honest, I kept that $30,000.
Wow.
Because I never saw $30,000 in cash before. And then when I found out from the record rep, what was that for? They said, hey, just welcoming you to town. But I knew what that meant. That meant the garbage that they were going to send, they were going to expect me to play. So I told everybody, and I admit it, after taking the money, don't send me any more money. I'm going to base my decisions on what I thought was best. And sometimes I understand why people sell out. Don't get me wrong. But if it's in your heart, it's tough, man. So I get a lot of heat for telling the truth. And, you know, the great thing is that I wanted to do it the right way. So about 5 years ago, after my mom passed, I had a little money saved up, and the FCC had a program that President Obama had. It's called Low Power FM. And there was a couple of stations available in Orlando. And me and my partner, we said, let's get this radio station. And it was a five-year process. And the place that we got the station was Pine Hills. And we knew nobody else was gonna apply for this station. Why? Because it was in the blackest part of town, with the highest crime, and we were right, it took 5 years. We launched in October 2016, and we had 13 murders within the first 40 days of the radio station, within a 3 mile radius of the radio station. You know, when, I can't think of Deborah Clayton. She died and the other officer. And it was just like a chain of murders that happened. And this radio station meant so much to me. We were doing it the old way. For so long, black radio and black music had so much power. So my dream was to put together a radio station that gave that same type of energy.